Hi, and welcome to 3dmotive.com. My name is Stephen G. Wells, and I'm a senior character artist. In this tutorial, we're going to take a look at quick polygon creation in Topogun. We're going to use a model of mine. It's a caricatured basketball player. It was for a game that ended up not being released, but I figured it would make a really good showpiece for this particular tutorial. Just something fun. Before we get started, I actually want to go over how you look at characters, what you should pay attention to for joints, and the areas that you're going to look to have more edge loops, like in the knees, in the neck, spine, things like that, than you would in the shin or upper thigh. So in Photoshop, I'm taking a shot of this particular character. I want to show you where you need to pay attention to for edge loops, because it's very important. You need to treat your character like it's an action figure or it's a puppet. It's going to have certain joints, and obviously it'll be in the shoulder, elbows, wrists, ankle, knees. The areas in between don't need a lot of edge loops. Obviously the areas that are going to be bending are the ones that you need to be concerned with, because that's where geometry will start to collapse or fold in on itself, or textures will stretch if you don't do the right edge loops. When you're creating the edge loops, you want to make sure you're generous with some of the edge loops. This is a quick diagram that I have done for my students before to show you, for at least from the neck down, about where the main joints are going to be. Obviously, the spine or the back has a lot more joints in it. We want to make sure it's going to form well. But basically, you have the joint in the shoulder, elbow, and wrist. You had one in the thigh, knee, and ankle. That's really where you need to make sure that you're putting in enough edge loops. The areas in between, you can be cheaper with polygons, and that's indicated by the red areas. And if you keep this in mind when you're getting ready to retopologize, whether using Topogun or 3D code or any of the other ones, it helps you establish where you're going to add in more polygons and more edge loops than in other areas. Especially if you're on a specific poly count, you need to pay attention to something like that. These green lines are showing about how the edge loops might be set up. See, there's more in the shoulder, but as I start to go down the arm, there's less in between, more in the elbows, less in the forearms, more in the wrist. And that's what you want to make sure you pay attention to. Same with the leg. There's more up in the thigh area, the joint, less in between, more in the knee, and less in the shin areas, but of course more as we get down towards the ankle. So it's you want to pay attention to that. So plan ahead. So when you retopologize the model, if you plan ahead appropriately, you get the work done that much quicker and better, and usually the first time around with a whole lot less mistakes with it involved. So once you have an idea of what you're going to do, we'll jump back into Topogun, and we'll look to do a quick create. Now, if you have, depending on what version of Topogun you're using, there's two different versions at least out there. There's one that has this tool called Tubes, which is this particular one right here. Imagine it's going to create a cylinder for you based on how you draw in, again, what we talked about earlier, the edge loops. So you want to make sure that you have enough polygon, enough sides to your model. And usually with limbs, I find about 12. A 12-sided cylinder tends to do pretty well. So if you remember, we're going to kind of base this on what we just did in Photoshop. We'll go ahead and just see these particular lines. We want to try and kind of follow those. Keep those at least in mind when we're doing this drawing out, or as we're adding in the edge loops using the tubes tool. So here I am just drawing. I'm just left click, drag. Okay. Make sure you stay in one, as you're drawing these, stay in one direction. If you change the direction, you'll wonk up all the polygons, because it's based on, the same direction. If you're creating the polygons all in one direction, you'll have perfect geometry. So keep that in mind. Once I'm done with this, I'm just going to right click. And now, as you can see, I can rotate the model around, and that's actually not bad right off the bat. It looks like it could probably deform pretty well. But you do want to keep in mind, I probably have to add in a couple of more extra edge loops down by the knee where the pants were the cutoff. It was kind of a bit of a jump there. So let's go ahead. Now, if you don't happen to have the tubes tool in your particular version of Topogun, I'll show you how to do this very simply with the simple create button, how I like to do it. By the way, these controls, if I'm panning around right now, it uses Maya, the Maya controls. So it's the left click Alt to rotate, middle button Alt to pan, and right button Alt to zoom in and zoom out. Again, so that's left click there, Alt for rotate, middle mouse Alt pan, right mouse Alt zoom in zoom out. So let me just zoom in a little bit. I'm going to go ahead and start with the one edge loop that's up in the joint of the thigh area. So I'm just left clicking. That's all I'm doing with this. This is the simple create button. So I'm just going to rotate the model around. Left click. Again, I'm creating my own cylinder, if you will. I'm going to go ahead and down to the farthest extent. Again, remember, we're piecing this up. Imagine it's a marionette. So this is now the one piece for just the thigh itself. We're not looking to do the knee or anything else at this point. I held down my control key just to snap that up. Okay. And now I'm going to go ahead and fill in the rest of the polygons with the simple create. Now, you keep having to switch out of create, the simple create, to simple edit. If you don't, it creates problems. So keep the control, hold down your control key and stay in the simple create. But here's what will happen. If you don't get back into simple edit and then go back into simple create, this is the problem. You can't get out of it. So Control-Z. Make sure that as you're creating, at least with this method, create your polygon, get into simple edit. Create your polygon, get back into simple edit. Just keep switching. Again, I'm holding down my control key. Control. That's how you snap from vertice to vertice, is using the control key. And I'm just doing the simple create, simple edit, simple create, simple edit. And this is the way out that I do it. This is what I was using before Topogun came out with the tubes tool. And again, like I said, you might be using a version of Topogun where you don't have the tubes tool. So this is really great practice to get you used to how you would create the joints of your model and the polygons in between. All right, so let's go ahead and we're just going to do a quick bridge there and there. I only did it in those that two areas because Bridge understands that small gap. If I try to do it at such a far extent on the two edge loops, it wouldn't have worked. But now I have to get into my simple edit, and we're going to grab just the edges. So I'm going to turn off my verts, and I'm going to double click one edge, and it selects them all. I'm going to go to connect, hit connect, and it just created that edge loop for me. I'm going to do it again and hold down my shift and select this one and double click. Connect. Boom. You basically have it. It's like, okay, there you go. Now, obviously, I want more edge loops in here because it's that joint area up in the inner thigh. So we're going to double click that. Very simple, very quick. You can turn around and do your entire model. I could do the legs that way. Obviously, I'd do the arms this way if I didn't have the tubes tool. Again, the tubes tool is great. I'm going to go ahead and add. I just double clicked on that edge. I want to add in another set of edge loops in there. I'm now going to move, I'm going to get into my verts tool, and I'm just going to left click and hold each vertice. I'm just going to drag it out a little bit, space it out a little bit more. Now, sometimes, it's rare, but sometimes you get these little gaps now that are there, and yet they're kind of not. Connect sometimes does that. So in order to fix that, I just have to get into my edge tool. I'll just delete that edge, and I'll go for this one. And then back to bridge, seal it, and go back. I'm going to select this edge and delete it. Go back to bridge, seal it, and select this edge, delete it, and hit the bridge tool and seal it. Now, it doesn't always do that. I'm just kind of surprised it did on this particular model, but for the most part, it tends to work really well. And you don't get those errors, but that's how you fix it. You just grab an edge, delete it, and then rebridge that area. But there you go. It's very quick, very simple, especially if you don't have the tubes tool. It's a great way to make the polygons as you need them very quickly, very easily, following edge loops to make yourself an in-game low-resolution model. It's very quick, very simple. You could turn around and do the rest of the limbs that way and then mirror all the geometry, and you'd be done pretty quickly with the body itself. The only thing you need to take some time with is modeling the face, technically. By the way, you can also, for this particular model, if you'd like, you can actually use the tube tools to actually create a good start for your mesh for the actual trunk of the body. It's really a great tool if you happen to have it. And then just seal it all up and add in the polygons as you need and do some mirroring and get your character done pretty quickly. And that's it. Thanks for watching 3dmotive.com, and my name is Stephen G. Wells.